The Las Vegas Grand Prix weekend is now in full swing, and the drivers have had their first taste of what the next 3 years of racing in Nevada will be like. With all the controversy surrounding the race and the negativity that preceded it, the drivers and teams have kept their opinions quiet. Now though, in front of the media, they've spilled the beans and their initial opinions are shocking. The opening ceremony was everything you expected it to be. In front of a half-full grandstand and eclectic selection of Las Vegas regulars, including Kylie Minogue, John Legend, and Steve Aoki, took to podiums placed along the pit straight. Once the atmosphere was officially turned up, I'm doing air quotes by the way, the F1 intro music played and the crowds got to see the drivers. It was a nice touch seeing Haas in first for once. It was probably tied between Red Bull and McLaren for the loudest cheer, but who knows how much of that was a physical crowd, and how much might have been crowd noise played to turn it up even more. But anyway, as Formula One fans, we're far more interested in the actual racing and on-track action than what was basically a very expensive concert in a parking lot in Las Vegas. One driver has been extremely vocal about his opinions on making F1 more about the show than the racing. He's been the loudest voice in opposition to sprint races since their inception, so you can only imagine what he thought of the opening ceremony. Max Verstappen criticized the 99% show, 1% sporting event nature of this weekend's inaugural Las Vegas Grand Prix and lambasted Wednesday's opening ceremony. This is a self-funded $500 million gamble by Formula One, and as much as they would want to keep their biggest star quiet, Max isn't someone who is easy to shush. For the most part, Formula One has done a good job of keeping the media positive about the race, but let's see if they can keep it that way after the weekend. Though, if it is as disastrous as some think it may be, at least it'll be a great watch. Three-time world champion Verstappen, who was among the 20 drivers dramatically introduced to the crowd during Wednesday's lavish opening ceremony via a lift onto a string of podiums, did not pull any punches about the spectacle of the event in Sin City. "I don't like the things around it," said the Red Bull driver. "I'm looking forward to trying to do the best I can, but I'm not looking forward to this. For me, you can skip these kinds of things. It's just standing up there. You look like a clown." Despite his role as a Formula One driver, I don't think anyone would ever accuse Verstappen of loving the limelight. "I fully understand, and you can look at it two ways, business side or sports side. So of course I understand their side of it, I'm just voicing my opinion on the performance side of things." The opening ceremony and the pomp and circumstance surrounding it are just extras though, easily ignored if you aren't interested or bothered by them. It is the on-track racing that really matters, and Verstappen, who's won 17 of the 20 races in a season of utter domination, also labeled the new 17-turn track as not very interesting. "I don't think it's that exciting," he told the media on Wednesday. "Already for me, a street circuit is not very exciting, especially with these new cars, they're too heavy. Also, when you have low grip, that doesn't help. Of course, the scenery will look great, driving on the strip, but the layout itself is not the most exciting. In F1 cars, it's a lot more fun with a lot of high-speed corners, and around here, there are not that many high-speed corners. Having spent a few years reading and replying to all your comments on our videos, I've seen plenty of opinions on street tracks. There are a growing number of people who are a bit fed up with the poor quality of racing they provide. Of course, that is a generalization, and we have had some great street track races, but Verstappen at least is not expecting this to be one of them." Not everyone has been as negative as Max, though. Speaking in the FIA press conference, Hamilton argued the opposite side from Verstappen, insisting that the event should be given the benefit of the doubt before being judged. "I hear there are a lot of people complaining about the direction that Stefano Domenicali and Liberty has gone. But they're doing an amazing job," the seven-time world champion said. "The sport continues to grow. It is a business, and you will still see good racing here. It is a country to tap into and really captivate the audience. We needed to have at least two races in the US. One wasn't enough. And this is one of the most iconic and unique cities that they have here. It is a big show for sure, and it's never going to be like Silverstone, but maybe over time, the people in this community will grow to love the sport. Maybe the track will be good, and maybe it will be bad. It was so-so on the simulator, but don't knock it until you try it. As I said earlier, it will be the race that really convinces people." Luckily for Formula One, the nighttime temperatures for the weekend aren't looking as low as everyone expected, which means the worries over tires will be eased a bit. Hamilton didn't miss the opportunity to take a pot shot at Max's dominance this season though, saying, "From a racer's perspective, you want to have the best show here. If the track provides a race like Baku, which is one of the best races with lots of overtaking, then that would be amazing, rather than just one car disappearing into the distance." Whether Max will do his usual trick of breaking DRS and then disappearing into the distance, as Hamilton says, remains to be seen. At the last street race in Singapore, Red Bull really struggled due to the really bad quality of the track surface. The Marina Bay circuit was in desperate need of repaving. For a Formula One car, it was like driving over constant speed bumps for 5 kilometers. Red Bull suffered again at Austin with the Circuit of the Americas in desperate need of resurfacing due to subsidence, especially into Turn 1. Considering the amount of traffic the Las Vegas Strip gets, you might assume that the surface of the track would be just as bad, but that won't be the case, with those who have walked the track already describing it as a pane of glass, it's so smooth. Because of that, it seems unlikely that Max is going to spend much time staring at anyone's rear wing. That will give him plenty of time to admire his surroundings, including the massive Las Vegas digital sphere, which will dominate the skyline as the drivers head north from Turn 4 to Turn 10. The sphere is so massive that the operators have had to agree to not distract the drivers with it by showing certain colors. It won't display anything that might be misinterpreted by the drivers, with red, yellow, and blue colors in particular being a worry, as the drivers are looking for light panels at the side of the track featuring those. With most sessions running after sunset, the digital sphere will be bright in the driver's eyes as they try to spot their braking point to Turn 5, something Verstappen is worried about. That definitely is a distraction for me. I might end in the wall, so let's not do that, Max told the press. I hope they put something nice on it. Mercedes' George Russell was very glad they'd banned the sphere from showing red, yellow, or blue. It's going to be an interesting one, Russell said. We've often got LED lights around us, but never so much in your peripheral. And it's a pretty spectacular building, to say the least. I recognize why they've banned those three colors. I think with the vastness of that, if I saw a big red ball on there, I'd be backing off thinking it was a red flag. Let's hope the sphere doesn't cause any unexpected issues for the drivers. It will add to the spectacle for those attending, though. In a city known for its gambling, you had to win big to be able to afford to be among those attending. Originally, the cheapest three-day standing only general admission ticket cost roughly $500, dwarfing the price points of every other Grand Prix on the calendar. Meanwhile, at the other end of the spectrum, a host of absurd hospitality packages have been offered for seven-figure sums to satisfy high rollers. The pricing of the event has been very poorly received by fans around the world, not just those close enough to actually consider attending. Daniel Ricciardo has been fighting the corner of the average F1 fan, stating that a large proportion of fans are being excluded, adding that he would prefer if the chance to attend was available to people from every background. Ricciardo said, "It's hard. As with all things, you need a balance. But you do need, I did hear some entry-level prices. I'm well aware not everyone can afford those. So I would love that everyone can have the option to attend. It's obviously not mine. I'm not the business behind the sport. After all, this race is solely Formula One's, with an investment of around $500 million from the sport. The business model applied by ex-F1 boss Bernie Ecclestone was to get circuits to pay to host the race and market it, meaning Formula One had to spend very little. It was a very safe and very successful model for many years, but the new owners, Liberty Media, want to take a gamble, and if you want to win big, you have to spend big. The exorbitant ticket prices are definitely a reflection of that." What have your impressions of the race weekend been so far? And are you surprised by anything the drivers have said about it? Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below, and if you want more F1 news and analysis like this, then subscribe to the channel. Until next time, drive safe and bye for now.